Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of HOPStart. Today's episode is great. It's a dynamic duo of me and Bhavya, and we interview two different people. I interview someone who's trying to make, you know, food a different kind of service. And Bhavya goes ahead and interviews a travelographer. So let's just get started.
Hi, I'm Shubham Maheshwari, the founder of Being Chef, and we are a startup in food space in which we are trying to solve the problem of daily food of millennials, giving them a solution which is nutritionally managed, tailored as per their body's requirement.
Hi Shubham, thank you for taking time out of your busy day to let us interview you. So roughly, what is Being Chef?
In Being Chef, we are providing you a one-stop solution for your daily food requirements. So, you may be consuming food in four different types. Either you can have a daily meal, which you can subscribe through a nearby auntie, or you can order food from Zomato, Swiggy, or any of the food ordering portals, or you can cook it yourself, or you can hire a maid. So, in all these four, channels,
yeah,
there are multiple problems which we are trying to solve, and we want to provide you a one-stop solution.
Okay.
And you don't have to run here and there for different modes.
Okay, so you're saying it's a one-stop platform for these four things. How do you do that exactly?
Okay, so let's say, so there are basically two major parts in food ordering. One is a la carte food ordering, another one is in a subscription-based food ordering, right? In a la carte, either you can order food in a kind of an a la carte mode only, in which you're ordering multiple vegetables and other dishes, or you can order a compact meal box. Right, so in meal box, the major problem in terms of thalis that you order is that you cannot reheat the food, or you cannot customize it. So generally, you end up eating the same kind of dal, paneer, and vegetable on a daily basis.
True.
So what we do is kind of give you an option to customize multiple vegetables, multiple paneer. So we will not say that we will give you shahi paneer. We'll give you, okay, from a list of 5-6 options, you select which paneer you want to have,
okay,
which dal, which, even the breads, right?
Okay.
So it's purely customizable. Make your own meal box, and everything is delivered in different containers, through which you can easily microwave them. And for females, generally, who have a lesser appetite for food, so if the food is being, food is remaining, so they can consume it later, which is not possible in thali because you have to dispose it of then and there, right? So there's a lot of food wastage happening in terms of this. In a la carte food ordering, there are multiple problems that you face in terms of ordering different portion size, in terms of, let's say, if you're ordering for bulk, initially, when you used to order via call, you were, kind of asking discount. Bhaiya, discount de do, 20%, 25%. Now it's an online thing.
Yeah.
So you don't have a differential, if you don't have a differential pricing thing, it's a kind of a loss for a customer. So we have done a differential pricing scheme in which, so we have divided multiple portions, 4-1, 4-2, 4-4. Let's say 4-1 is for 100 bucks, 4-2 would not be 200, it would be a discounted price. 4-4 would be a more discounted price.
Yeah.
So you don't have to ask for discount when you're ordering for bulk.
Okay.
Moreover, we have given an option in which it's known as party pack, in which most of the time you end up ordering food when there are like 3-4 people visiting your place.
Hmm.
And when your friends coming over, you have to I order all starters, main course, dessert. And it's a very, I would say, a tedious process in which you have to select, okay, first of all, what I had to order.
Yeah.
Then secondly, how many portions I have to order, right?
So
we give you a simple solution.
Hmm.
You just go on our app and kind of select, okay, these are the number of persons coming for my party, and this is the basic constant of menu that I want. And then you can just easily, within 2 minutes, select the options and can check out.
So then, just correct me if I'm wrong, then you make the food on your own, so the food is yours, or do you source the food from existing restaurants and then like package it?
Okay, so food is purely ours. We have been running a kitchen from past 5 years.
Okay.
And apparently it's one of the biggest kitchens of Gurgaon. So yeah, food is our forte, and food production is totally in our
control. That's interesting. And so then therefore, do you focus more on Indian food, or you have like a continental Indian?
Okay. So we wanted to provide a solution for veg food. There's a huge void in veg food space in India. So if you see, there is no national brand, as in like a prominent brand, which is like a McDonald's for veg food, right? So you wanted to enter into that space, which is totally full of, full of opportunity, which is untapped. So in veg, we do all multiple cuisines. So we are not constrained to Indian or maybe continental, something like that. It's purely chart se leke, you do all the cuisines.
Okay. So Shubham, how did you get, you know, started with Being Chef? What is your story that connects you to Being Chef?
Okay, so it was quite an interesting story. So I did my engineering from NIT Jaipur, and while I was doing engineering over there, so I accidentally got a kind of an opportunity in which I was coordinating the India Against Corruption movement in Rajasthan. So entire Rajasthan, I was quite young, I was I guess 20 at the time. And it was quite a different experience in which we organized a rally of 70,000 people for India Against Corruption. And that was the day I decided that, okay, I want to devote my life for society and I want to kind of stay in India. I don't want to go to abroad as most of my colleagues were planning to go to. So it's like, I'll stay in India and I'll kind of try working on something in which we can create some opportunity for Indians and kind of give it back to the society. And then when I graduated from the college, I was lucky enough to get into a consulting firm, a US-based consulting firm. It was a dream job for most of the engineering students, and it was a day zero placement. So I thought, okay, let's join this and kind of see. It was like, I was not about clear about the idea on which I have to pursue. So when I joined this company, so, you know, we were struggling, you know, with daily food, because cooks are any which ways, you can also understand that cooks are very irregular. And moreover, they would have a very limited kind of a knowledge in terms of recipe, if I say, right? So they would generally end up cooking something with aloo. So it was like aloo patta gobi, aloo bhindi, aloo this. And so moreover, you have to kind of manage your own kitchen, as in like you have to bring all the ingredients. And they would always have a excuse to say, bhaiya, aapne ye saman nahi laya, bhaiya, aap ye nahi laya, to aaj wapis se aloo bana dega. So ghum fir ke, it was most of the time aloo, aloo, aloo. And then one fine day, we were like kind of sitting and chilling, and then we were watching movie, and at 3 o'clock in the night, we had that, you know, that hunger bite, and I was like, okay. And I am talking about 2013, and there was no such option like Zomato, no Food Panda, Swiggy. There was nothing like that, no midnight delivery. So we thought, yeah, engineering kar liya, matlab rocket science to hai nahi, cook kar lenge. So we entered into kitchen, and then we started cooking. So we put up a video of I don't remember exactly Tala Dala or Sanjeev Kapoor, and we were like, okay. First we saw that there was no ingredient available apart from potato and onions. It's like aloo pyaaj hi hai yaar, aloo hi hai, to theek hai, aloo pyaaj ka sabji banate hain. And then we, obviously no one was that much enthusiastic to make breads, as in like, you know, atta laga ke and everything. So like, okay, we'll cook rice and some tari wala aloo pyaaj ka sabji. And then we started cooking it, and then we realized that it's not as easy as just shown in a video. In video, everything is already pre-chopped, pre-processed, and within 2 minutes sabji ban gaya. For us, it's like you have to do all the process, do all the processing and other stuff. And that was the time then it realized, kicked me, okay, let's induce, I did my mechanical engineering, let's induce mechanical into food and create a product through which we can simplify this whole cooking process.
So then any advice you'd like to give to people who, you know, also trying to get out, young entrepreneurs, trying to make their own companies, what, like something that maybe you did right or you did wrong that they could learn from?
Okay, so a few things that I've learned in this whole journey is that, first of all, never get demotivated. I mean, if you're entering into entrepreneurship, you have to be really sure that you want to enter into it, because it's not a rosy journey. Like whatever story we see in your story and other portals or all the media portals, it's all the success story. But success story is, I think, not even 2% of, and 98% of failure. But this perception that if you will fail, then you know you will never get back again. Failure gives you much more learning than a success, right? And it's good to fail an initial day, so that, you know, when you have a larger thing at stake, you don't end up failing at that time. So it's like you should be really persistent. You should be, you know, kind of. So I had a lot of tough times in which, you know, I've also traveled in a shared auto, you know, of 10 rupees. Whenever I used to go to a meeting, I would avoid, okay, let's kind of skip meals or something like that. So I have had my tough times. But the only thing that, you know, kept me going on was that my conviction for the idea. This is going to work. And, you know, sooner or later, things will get work. All the ideas are feasible ideas. It's always about the execution. So there is no such idea which is totally, you know, you cannot say that this is not a feasible idea, right?
Yeah.
Everything is feasible, everything can be done. It's just about the execution. And execution has to come from within, so yeah.
Fair enough. Thank you so much, Shubham. This has been like great. I'm kind of hungry now thinking about it, but thank you. Thank you.
All right, yeah. Thank you, man.
Bye.
Hi, I'm Kapil Arora, co-founder and CEO Travographer. Hi Kapil.
Hi Bhavya.
So ये Travographer आपने ये जवानी दीवानी के बाद start करा था कि पहले?
Obviously yes. After listening to Ilahi's song, I was a lot inspired by that. We need to follow our
like passion. The rest of the generation, I think.
Yes, a lot of rest of the they were inspired. A lot of people who were in my group also were entrepreneurs. I think I became that one of the entrepreneurs who thought of leaving corporate job of a chartered accountant and start doing what I actually want to do. And what a lot of people who are fond of travel, photography.
Correct.
Two super awesome words.
Important combination. However, people who don't know what Travographer is, can you tell them what that is?
Travographer is a local photographer in 100 plus countries. You are traveling, do not focus on taking selfies, do not focus on asking people, can you please click my bestest moment of life and during a sunset? No. Just focus on creating memories out of those 7-10 days in your complete year and let a local photographer come along, click beautiful candid pictures of yours, make them a piece of art and deliver them in just 24 hours.
Fantastic. So I don't need to like badger my sister anymore or my brother that
not
please click my
and
pictures?
Not even your driver or any local person hesitate, sir, one picture,
one
can you
picture.
Please click? Not at all. Travel
so they accompany you on all your trips wherever you
yes.
go? And what's the process for that?
Simple process. Go on to our website, travographer.com, tell the location, select the package, pay the photographer, everything is confirmed and right away at that point of
Fantastic.
Time.
Fantastic. So do you have also like packages and all?
Yeah, we do have different packages. You want a complete end-to-end cinematic feel of Ilahi in Paris.
Wow.
Or you want a photo shoot across our city tour. Or you want like DDLJ like poses in different locations of Europe. Every single thing.
Fantastic.
At monuments. So all wow. different packages are being made.
So Kapil, who came up with this idea?
Okay. So I was a avid traveler and so I'm a chartered accountant. I was working with Ernst & Young prior to this into risk and assurance. I've worked with Fortune 500 companies. I used to travel a lot.
Okay.
And eventually I noticed that I have somewhere around 25,000 of pictures.
Correct.
But I don't have good pictures to post on my social media. We are
right.
we are a generation of Instagram or social
Absolutely,
media.
Yes.
I don't have that. Eventually and every time I'm traveling or my cousins are traveling, everybody is like, can you please click this picture of mine? Can you please that picture?
I know.
One of the problems.
It gets very frustrating.
It is indeed. And eventually, if you are that photographer in the group, you are only there to click their pictures. You are not able to memorize their
Absolutely.
Journey. This happened with me in 2015 when I was in a desert safari trip in Dubai. One of my desert safari in Dubai is very, very over. It's good actually across
right.
complete India. And everybody across, not even my relatives, the other person who were traveling in desert safari, excuse me, can you please click this picture of her? And I was also, because the sunset timing is just of 10 minutes.
Right.
Sun is setting and I want to also enjoy that Christmas time.
Correct.
I was not able to do that.
Right.
Actually, I thought that people
so
need
this.
So
victimization led to this discovery.
I was actually the victim of that. So I, that day I came back and I discussed the concept with my co-founder that is this a real problem? We did research and found that there are 4 billion travelers traveling annually for one place to another for leisure. And even as per the studies, you know, done by the Telegraph and a lot of other newspapers and agencies, 33% of millennials travel to post pictures.
Wow.
One of so there's a humongous market size and there's no one who is catering to it.
Makes me feel how shallow our generation is, by the way.
We need to capture good memories. You
That's
know,
true.
Our
Absolutely.
Secondary memory, we look for the good thing happening. And when we are in low in time, okay, hum wahan gaye the, hamari picture, and when, you know, have you seen that on your Facebook or Insta? In Facebook, a year back you were doing this, 5 years
yes,
back you were doing
you
this.
You get those memories repeatedly.
We are just bringing a memory lane from your travel back with
Fantastic.
Good pictures.
Fantastic.
Otherwise, your pictures are blur, not in focus, everything. So
Absolutely.
We are just revamping, you know.
I feel like you're discussing how my father clicks all my pictures.
but I'd
love to know what your journey has been, man.
So, okay, I was a chartered accountant. I was working into risk and assurance business consultancy division, traveling, doing audits, asking questions, doing audits, asking questions, doing audits. Faced this a problem statement.
Right.
And my other co-founder, Deepak Bansal, quite a guy. The person I admire from day one when I started CA, we connected 5 years back in Lakshmi Nagar.
Okay.
The most humble and nicest guy or chartered accountant I've ever seen in my life, I admire. And then to till date, and I'm very much sure in future as well. So I discussed this idea with him. He brainstormed a lot more into it and we started working on it. And it was in July 2016, he was also frustrated out of something from his job. He asked me, will you quit your job? I don't know why on that Thursday I was in an audit, I said okay. Thursday, it was a review meeting that day, okay. I said okay. Saturday, I got up, when I put down my papers to my manager on Saturday, I got a very good opportunity.
Okay.
And I thought like, yeah, this is a good opportunity. I was earning good, I'm understanding. And in, you know, in, when you're in your early 20s, you're getting good opportunity to travel abroad. Absolutely. Just because of work. I saw episode one of Pictures twice that night, wherein the driver says to Naveen, sir, jab tak sadak pe jayenge nahi to pata nahi lagega hame. That was my eureka moment. I know it's very filmy, but it actually converted me. Till date, we have done approx 1 lakh passengers and 60,000 shoots in date.
Wow.
In 90 plus countries.
That's just insane.
And you know, in photography, there's one more part which we have taken care. A lot of photographers finds a pain in doing the editing and delivering the pictures on time to the client.
Right.
In our case, no.
You just have like separate editors for that?
We have a complete multi-layer artificial intelligence program.
Wow.
We are the only one to do that
and
right
what
now.
What does that mean?
So, okay. In last 2.5 years, we have been able to generate our own machine learning and artificial intelligence program with a set of data pictures which we have, who edits the picture and, you know, have reduced the turnaround time from 15 minutes to a minute to deliver the picture. Benefit to photographer, last click done, work over. Enjoy your evening in the beach.
Wow.
No editing, no delivery, kahan upload karna hai, nothing. Just give it to us, we'll take care of everything.
This is revolutionary.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kapil. I mean, this was really insightful. Besides, I also know now that Ilahi is not just a song, it's a way of life.
It's a way of, indeed, it's a way of life. And apart from photographers also, any person, you know, I truly believe from anywhere across the India or part, who is willing to join a very tremendous team, who is doing something revolutionary in this trade. We are creating this market, Bhavya. The market which is now becoming a trend, even a study by Bank Bazaar, or recently we got covered by Tribune Trends as well.
Wow.
That vacation photographer is a new trend. People are hiring photographer, and
the profession is called vacation photographer.
The new trend by paparazzi is the right
terminology.
Vacation photography is a new trend taken by paparazzi. Is that statement which was published by Tribune Trends. So any person who would love to join our team, not in specifically photography, in terms of creative part, designing, making people look more beautiful into their pictures, or want to do something with humongous data and do into technology, our gates are always open.
Wow. Thank you. Wow. This is, I'm telling you, this is very insightful. You have indeed told us today that Ilahi not just is a song, but
indeed.
Is a way of life. Thank
it
you
is.
So much, Kapil, for taking time out and telling us all about your travography.
Pleasure, Bhavya. Thank you.